Hey everybody, how you doing out there? It's a great old day. It's Sunday. Glad you guys are out there. I'm glad you guys are doing what you do best. You're doing photography. You know, the First Amendment. If you're a U.S. citizen and you're doing the First Amendment and you're doing photography, they call it the activity, whatever it is. You're allowed to film anything in public. Anything that public amusement, public area. You're allowed to film anywhere. And you have to be in a public areas to do this. But if you're a U.S. citizen, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the Fifth Amendment. Now, folks, you know why I'm talking about the Fifth Amendment? This is only for U.S. citizens from the United States. This is great for you people using this Fifth Amendment. You got privileges or things that ties to the Fifth Amendment. Now, this is not bad stuff. This might come in handy if you're ever in a court proceedings or a jury. And the judge starts saying, you want to plead the Fifth Amendment? Well, here's the Fifth Amendment. I'll tell you what the Fifth Amendment really means and stands for. It says it protects you as an individual of testifying oneself. It applies to that. That means you can't be, you don't have to testify on your behalf, essentially. That means that. And another thing that the Fifth Amendment, there's a lot of privileges here. And also, the laws state in the Fifth Amendment, they said a federal due process clause. So that means it's a federal clause. That means a due process. They call it a due process. Wait till it's finished, and then you waive your rights to, you know. This is only for the U.S. citizens. Remember, this is Fifth Amendment, folks. This is not like here in Canada. But in the Fifth Amendment, you get a lot of good privileges if you're ever in a court case or a trial going on. That's what the George Floyd, the judge in the George Floyd trial said to the complaint, as they would say. I said, do you want to plead the Fifth Amendment? And it's either a yes or a no. You can, they usually say, if you want to, if you want to invoke your Fifth Amendment, that means if you want to testify your own self, oneself kind of thing. That's in the Fifth Amendment. That's the privileges you get in the Fifth Amendment. This is only for U.S. citizens, mind you. It's not for the Canadians. This is for if you're in a trial or court proceedings. I'm surprised they don't use this very often. I said this yesterday when I was watching videos about this, explain what the Fifth Amendment really meant for the American citizens. And they get a lot of privileges. I mean, if you're ever in a court proceedings, this will come in handy. That means you don't have to testify your oneself. So if you're ever in a proceeding, this might come in handy for you people out there. Whatever situation you're in, and you're in a court proceedings, this one will come in handy. I'm surprised it's not well used in the United States, but that's what the George Floyd trial, what's this guy's name, who's on the stand, doesn't want to testify himself, or oneself, as they would say. His privilege is not to testify himself. That means you don't need to go on the witness stand and testify yourself. And what the ledge happened, kind of thing. So, this is only for the U.S. citizens. This is not Canadians. Canadians get a different kind of law stuff. But the American citizens, what I'm hearing, if I'm not mistaken, you get a lot of privileges to this. And the federal due process clause, that's what the federal people say in due process clause. They call it the due process clause. Let the proceedings play itself out and we'll see. And that's what the Fifth Amendment allows you to do. So you get a lot of privilege. You guys can read into what the Fifth Amendment really means to the American citizen. It's only for the United States citizens. Okay, I'll put that in the title, the subtitle. only for U.S. citizens, for the Fifth Amendment, not for the Canadians. But the Americans have it way too easy, as I would say, way too easy on the Fifth Amendment. So basically what I'm going to say to you folks, it protects against oneself criminalization by individuals. That's what it's saying here for the Fifth Amendment. So it gives you a lot of privileges. Essentially, it gives you a lot of privileges. So it helps you in a federal sense. It helps you when you're ever in a court proceedings or a trial, a court trial, I guess they call it court trials. And it really helps you out if you're ever in a, if you ever don't want to testify yourself. That means oneself, or as you as an individual. You don't have to testify yourself, so that's the Fifth Amendment, so you plead the Fifth Amendment. That's what it stands for the Fifth Amendment. I'm just gathering what I'm hearing about. And it's like tutorials on 101, what the Fifth Amendment really stands for. But this is only for the U.S. citizens, it's not the Canadians to use. It's only for the American citizens, so they have it easy with their amendments. And the First Amendment, which a lot of people you hear about on YouTube videos, they use it for photography. That's what they use the First Amendment for. They use it for photography, or First Amendment audits, or photographies they photographers would use. But yeah, you gotta know the laws when you're out there, folks. I kid you not. It comes in handy when you need it. It really comes in handy with a lot of things out in the world. Like, if you're American citizens, this is what you should use, the Fifth Amendment. If you're ever in a court proceedings or a trial, which they did in the George Floyd trial a few days ago, they used the Fifth Amendment. I'll put it on the subtitles. This is only for U.S. citizens, not the Canadians. Bear that in mind. This is for U.S. They have it so easy because of their amendments and their constitution. So what I'm trying to say here, folks, this is only for the U.S. citizens, and you get a lot of privilege. What the police officer did to George Floyd's neck, he said there a couple days ago, he's gonna revoke his Fifth Amendment right, which due process, he's gonna use the due process clause. He's gonna let it play out, and he's not gonna take the witness stand, essentially. So it's going to play it out the way it should be. You guys, if you're lawyers, if you're a guy who's a lawyer or attorney, this might come in handy because they know about the amendments to the Constitution. There's a lot of amendments out there, folks. You got to use them when you can. And this one is no difference. This will help you out with any court proceedings. If you're ever in court, this one will help you out. Or a trial. If you're ever in a court trial and you're a U.S. Citizen, this one might help you out. So there you go. So folks, I just read up on the Fifth Amendment. I got a crash course of what Fifth Amendment really stands for the American citizens. They have it way too easy because of the Fifth Amendment, just so you know. So there you go, folks. He waived his Fifth Amendment right, and he did. And if you ever live in the United States, you're allowed to use the Fifth Amendment right if you're ever in the court proceedings. So there you go, folks. I'll talk. This is only for the U.S. citizens, as it says. Okay, folks? Not for the Canadians. Canadians, we have different court... I forget. Ours is kind of different than the Americans. So... But yeah, you get a lot of... watch it on the screen here. The Fifth Amendment. So there you go, folks. I'm talking about the Fifth Amendment for you Americans out there. This one's for you. So just go research it. I did. And it was very fascinating to hear about all this Fifth Amendment stuff. And it's you get a double jeopardy out of the thing. And so there you go, folks. Go read up the Fifth Amendment, what it actually stands for. I don't have to tell you all this jargon stuff. You guys go research it and tell me if the American people have it way too easy, all because of the Fifth Amendment. You know, so there you go, folks. I'm going to talk about it right here on my video. It should, I'm surprised it's not well used in the court proceedings or trial. But you have those privileges to use the amendments, like the Fifth Amendment to your First Amendment. The First Amendment only gives you the freedom to protest in a nice way. You can protest out there, like you see recently in the United States. You can protest peacefully, but it doesn't have to get out of hand. You can be protesters and not damage any property to, you know what I mean. So you can protest whenever you want because that gives you the First Amendment right to do so. And that's where you go. That's what the United States people have. The First Amendment to assemble, as they would say, peacefully. And that's what they're trying to do. They don't want to be Antifa or the Black Lives Matter group, which I've seen in the live streams a couple of times. And these are people with mixtures. And one guy says there's just a mixture of people. It could be that. I could be wrong what I'm saying here, folks. It could be a mixture of people. It could be the Black Lives Matter. Could be Antifa. Could be all sorts. So it's a mixture of people that were at the protest. So it could be people who want to join the protesting. It could be people who are very strongly on the Black Lives Matter. I call it the All Lives Matter. It's not the Black Lives Matter. One guy said on the live stream, he says, it's only a sign. That's it. From that point on, it's only a sign. But I think he's right about that. It should be all lives matter. Not just the black people, but all lives matter. Because you're singling out the white people. It's not just the black people. You're singling out the white people. So it's all lives matter. It's just the black people. It's the all people around the world. So you may consider yourself all lives matter, not the black people. They have these signs out there saying Black Lives Matter. It's only for the black people. It's not for the white people. It's for the black people. But it should be all lives matter, folks. So there you go, folks. But yeah. So let's get on the topic here, folks. So I'm talking about the Fifth Amendment. I'll put it here on the subtitles. You guys do the research. I think the Americans have it way too easy because of the Fifth Amendment. I really do think so. If you're ever in a trial or court proceedings, this might come in handy if you're an American citizen. Sometimes the Fifth Amendment will come in handy if you're ever in a court proceedings or a trial, trial thing. This might come in handy. I was very surprised that they didn't use they don't use this very often. But it sounds, when I heard about it, it sounds pretty good. So if you're ever in a trial and you want to plead the Fifth Amendment, you can do so if you're an American citizen. Only for the American citizen. So bear that in mind, folks. So, yeah. So